Hello, everybody. Happy Hump Day Wednesday. Have you watched that State of the Union speech yesterday by President Trump? What do you think? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Neutral? Yeah, tell me. How did you like that 2009 February President Trump's speech yesterday? The State of the Union speech. So to speech. Well, I guess if you are a huge fan of President Trump, and I guess you'll like him no matter what he does, okay? And that's what I'm concerned about, okay? Many times presidency becomes an idolatry, not just President Trump. President Bush, President Reagan, President Obama, every American presidency has some idolatrous element in it. Okay, President Bill Clinton, all past presidents, not just in America, in any country. Oh, you think, well, North Korea is bad because they idolizes, what, Chairman Kim Jong-un or Kim Il-sung, Kim Jong-il, in any dictatorial country like Stalin or, well, America is doing the exact same thing. So democracy isn't that much different from those dictatorial countries. Despotic countries, those tyrant countries. America isn't that much different, okay? Essentially, it's the same. It's the idolatry of one king. And that's what really disgusted me yesterday. So I had to stop watching, okay? I watched maybe first 5 minutes or less than that. And he's like, oh, yeah, I'm president. State of Union speech is always like that. Okay, it's not just President Trump. No, it's the State of the Union, this annual event. It's very highly idolatrous, no matter who the president is. Oh, man, this stupid president, President Obama or President Trump, they always get like standing ovation. I got disgusted because they're getting all the credits for whatever went well, right? If I'm the president, there will be no State of the Union speech, okay? There won't be any, okay? You wanna hear from me? I will speak in the White House. It will be just me and the cameraman, that will be it. There will be no audience because this isn't time to celebrate, really. It's time to work. And also it's time to be efficient. I mean, all these congressmen, these senators, they fly from, well, these 50 different states to attend this event, State of the Union. I mean, where does the money come from? Taxpayers, okay? This should stop. When I'm the president, I will send back all the congressmen and senators back to their states. I will not have them in Washington, D.C. Why? Because they should be taking care of their own people. Okay, not they should not be in Washington, D.C. What are they doing in Washington, D.C.? Uh-huh. Okay, they need what? Congressional session, meeting? Okay, why don't you use some internet? Teleconference. Okay? I mean, all those congressional sessions, not, it's mostly empty anyway. Haven't you seen those ESPN? The senators, congressmen, they don't even attend those sessions anyway. So why wasting taxpayers' money having multiple offices everywhere? They should stop doing that, okay? So congressmen, senators, yeah, go back to your freaking state, okay? Don't come to Washington, D.C. because we're so crowded here in Washington, D.C. I'm not in D.C., but if I do become the president, I'll send them all back to their own freaking state, okay? They should not be. What do they come to Washington, D.C. for? Well, to get in bed with lobbyists, right? Probably that's why they come to Washington, D.C. Ha! Stupid. They shouldn't be wasting taxpayers' money flying here, flying there, and having this and that multiple offices, and no. This needs to stop. One of my campaign slogan is, give money and power back to the people, okay? No more elitocracy, no more plutocracy, no more rule by money, rule by elite. No, this needs to stop. Okay, I know I'm kind of sounding like a socialist and communist, you know, oh bourgeoisie, bourgeois class. I know what I sound like, but I'm not talking about anti-capitalism. Capitalism is fine, okay? The wealth, unequal distribution of wealth, is, I see it as a diversity, okay? As long as, at least in theory, upward class mobility is possible, then yeah, the unequal distribution of wealth is fine. It's a diversity, okay? I'm like probably lower middle class, okay? I'm very poor, man. All these nice dresses is from secondhand store, my friend. And the only supermarket I can afford to go to is Walmart. There are some expensive supermarkets, right? I cannot go there. But what, do I hate rich people? No, I don't. The daughters of rich people, they are the prettiest girls, right? Rich man's daughters. Because if there's a rich man, he probably get a very beautiful wife, right? And their daughter will be very beautiful. So yeah, rich man's daughter, rich parents' daughter, they tend to be, yeah, rich man, beautiful mother. So yeah, they make the most beautiful daughters. So I appreciate that, okay? So. Although I only get to watch them, I don't even get to watch them. Where are all the pretty girls? I don't get to watch them at all. But every now and then, I go to those expensive supermarkets because there are some special toothbrushes that only those expensive stores sell. So yeah, sometimes I go there. And then, yeah, I get to see those beautiful young girls and basically rich man's daughters. Otherwise, I never get to see them. Ever. Ever. Why? Because, you know, the place I work, bars or clubs I go to, they're all like dive bars. Like, bars and clubs for people like me. Poor people. If I never get to go to like fancy restaurant, expensive restaurants, maybe every now and then. Like once a year, right? Once a year, maybe. Then, yeah, I get to see all these beautiful young girls. But otherwise, I never get to see beautiful girls because the places they go to, because they are rich men's daughters, they are rich themselves, I don't get to go to those expensive places, wherever it may be. Restaurant, supermarket, or some big corporation building or fancy places like that. I don't get to go there because I'm a very poor man. Okay? I make probably less than American salary. Or maybe just average American salary. I don't know. Probably just about American salary. Average American salary, right? I look it up if you don't know what that is. Average American salary. That's what I'm making. Why? Because I could have made more money. But to me, what's more important is not money, but freedom, liberty. To me, liberty is more important than money. Why? Because I enjoy not working, okay? Maybe you may call me lazy. Oh, you're lazy. No, I'm working, but I'm working for free. This, humanology, human analytical economics, this is something I love to do, but it doesn't make any money. It's a hobby. Also running for president, for example. Yeah, it's a hobby, something I really enjoy doing. But does it make money? No. But do I enjoy it? Yes, absolutely. So that makes me happier than money. What's money for? I don't need that much money. I'm living by myself, so, okay. Yeah, so that's that. And what else do we talk about? Let me turn on the heater real quick, okay? I'll be right back.
It's getting chilly.
Okay. So, I used to like President Trump a lot. A lot. I voted for him. I prayed for his election. And when he got elected, I almost cried because I was so happy. And he was cool for a while, and then there was this first sign of something was wrong. Like when he fired James Comey, okay, because he helped him to get elected, because James Comey, you know, FBI director, he went after Madam Secretary Hillary Clinton just before the election, and that helped President Trump greatly. And now he stabbed James Comey in the back. He betrayed his biggest ally who helped him get elected. To me, that's unacceptable. Betrayal. James Comey got him the presidency. Practically, okay? President Trump got elected because of James Comey, FBI director, and he fired him, okay? To me, that's the unacceptable betrayal. So I was very disappointed. It was a first disappointment. And progressively, he got worse and worse, okay? I mean, there are things that I like he's doing. He's doing good things with the border wall, immigration policy. Yeah, yeah, I support that. But then he overdid it, okay? He almost tried to kick me out, people like me out of the country based on my national origin, okay? Making impossible requirement to renew my passport. Oh. So that's the second big disappointment. And his comment, his attitude about this African country or Virgin Island, or not Virgin Island. Virgin Island is a U.S. territory, right? But some other, what country was that? Yeah, he basically called many countries shithole countries. Developing third world countries, shithole country. That's not acceptable. Attitude. Why does he talk like that? Because he's an elite. look at him. He lives in a penthouse in Manhattan, okay? He's a rich guy. All his friends are rich people. They all went to Harvard, Yale, Ivy Leaguers, right? They are born rich and they grew up rich and they have never experienced average American life. So do they care about middle income class people like you and me? They don't. They only care about themselves, how to maintain their established class. Okay, you have to know this. They don't care, they only care about themselves. They're all like that, okay? All these privileged people. President Obama was a little bit different because he was quite born poor, right? He grew up in a single mother, under a single mother, but at the same time, he had this huge inheritance from the civil rights era because he's half black. He's partially, he's not 100% black. I mean, Senator Cory Booker, I don't think he's 100% black either. He's a very light-skinned person. Senator Cory Booker, who runs for president as a Democrat candidate, he's not black. He's kind of like President Obama, half black, half probably half white, right? And they claim, oh, I'm black. Just like Senator Elizabeth Warren, who claimed, oh, I'm a native. She looked like mostly white. Yeah, I think, yeah, she's like maybe 10% Native American and 90% white, something like that. I can see some trace of American Native, this Indian heritage in her face. Yeah, kind of flat, you know. Yeah, so I believe her, but, oh, you're just 10% Native American. It's not like you're, you know. So yeah, they inherit that ethnicity, you know, being an ethnic, and they get a lot of boost. Like President Obama, for example, yeah, when he went to Harvard Law School, yeah, he got super duper extra points for just being half black. He claimed this, oh, I'm black. No, you are only half black, but still. Yeah, so they gave him Harvard Law School admission extra points, okay? And they give him Harvard Law Review extra points, and then University of Chicago Law School professorship extra points. Just because he's like half black, okay? So yeah, he gets some that kind of metaphysical inheritance, metaphysical wealth, asset as a half black man, okay? It's all from civil rights era, okay? The past racism, the pain and suffering, and the past racism in America. Yeah, they worked very hard. They suffered painful, you know, African Americans. And President Trump, Senator Barack Obama Trump or law school student Obama, he inherited that asset. Okay, pain and suffering from the past African Americans. But his father isn't exactly African American. Isn't he kind of new immigrant from Africa or something? So yeah, it's all so garbage, okay? So you have to understand all this famous presidential candidates, they lie a lot. They deceive you, okay? So President Trump, for example, he pretend I represent blue class or all these forgotten Americans. No, he doesn't. He was born rich, okay? He inherited every single thing that he has. Oh yeah, he worked hard, of course. But he inherited business savvy from his father. Connection, networking, yeah, it's all from his father, okay? I mean, he went to basically free job training under his father as he grew up, okay? All this connection, human connection, all that stuff. He basically got it for free, okay? So he's not a blue collar. He's just what, white male, that's it. But does he care about middle class? No, he doesn't, okay? Because I filed tax last year and this year, okay? My tax went up as a middle class person. My tax went up because I had to pay. I didn't get any refund, but I was owing money to federal government. So obviously something happened, right? I'm making about the same level salary, okay? But last year, this year, ever since President Trump got elected, my tax went up. because during the Obama administration, I was getting some refund. How much? Maybe $500. Yeah, but still, it was something, right? But last year and this year, I was owing money, like about $500, $600, $700, whatever. The tax went up since President Trump got elected. I have some business owner friends, and they say, yeah, their tax went down. Business tax. So, that's what President Trump did, I think, in the, his tax, new tax policy. He lowered income, the income tax for business owners. So they got benefited, you know, rich people basically. And I think he raised the tax level for people like us, just lower middle income class. Okay? So he does not really represent us at all. Okay, he represents rich people. He lowers tax for the rich. Okay? And he said he created many jobs. So what? I didn't get any benefit from it. Not at all. I'm making about same salary level, and the only thing that happened to in my finance is my tax went up. Okay? Ever since President Trump got elected. Okay? So that's all again. Third disappointment. Okay, so and yeah, he said he created jobs where I'm not getting any benefit from it. And I'm not even sure if that's true. The report, all this Fox News, this all this media report saying, oh, the unemployment rate went down. First of all, I don't get any benefit from it. Second of all, I'm not even sure if that's correct report, because media is so biased nowadays. I'm not sure what I can trust, okay? And in terms of immigration policy, I mean, his policy idea is good. There is this huge flux from South America now. I think it has to do with him pulling out American manufacturers out of South America. Do you think it's a coincidence? Ever since President Trump got elected, yeah, he tried to bring back all this South American, you know, outsourcing. Like Ford or GM or all these big American companies outsourcing to South America. So he brought all those jobs back, right? Now what happens? This illegal immigration, huge flux, because I guess now they lost their jobs. Once used to be American company job in South America. So they lost jobs and they are coming to America. Looks like that's what's happening. I don't think it's coincidence, this huge caravan of immigrants, and ever since President Trump got elected, okay? All this huge caravan from South America, it started after President Trump got elected, okay? Probably because he pulled back all this American outsourcing to South America, okay? And I think that's a bad thing, bad, bad idea, okay? All this, even if there was this job gain, this less unemployment, even if that's true, I think it's very short-term gain. I don't think it's a long-term gain, okay? I just don't think it's a good idea to bring back those labor-intensive jobs back to America, because America is a developed country, developing country. They are happy with labor-intensive jobs, okay? I know this because I lived in both worlds. I grew up in Seoul, South Korea. Back then, it was a developing country. Maybe it still is, okay? Then I came to America, a developed country. There are two different levels, two different stages in evolution, in this societal, economical development. Developing countries like Vietnam or Bangladesh, they embrace, they love this. They have no problem labor with this labor intensive jobs like manufacturing or making clothing and making shoes. They have no problem with that. Why? because they used to be more farming based or sometimes even starved, famine, whatever, right? Now all these other countries like China, South Korea or America, they're outsourcing and they start building factories in Bangladesh or Vietnam. They embrace that because it's something new. Okay? So restoring manufacturing job to America, that's very, very bad idea. Ignorant idea. And President Trump is doing that because he's fucking ignorant. I'm sorry to use S-bomb on him. If he happened to be your idol, your God, your prophet, your Jesus, your savior, your hero, I'm sorry if I'm offending you, but he's wrong. He's very ignorant. He doesn't understand history. Okay? Very ignorant man. Okay, so liberals, they are correct. He's very ignorant guy. Okay? Intelligence has never been his strength, okay? He may have some good sense of humor. Like calling Senator Elizabeth Warren Pocahontas. Yeah, this is kind of funny. By the way, I like some music from Pocahontas, this Disney movie. Like, If I Never Knew You or something. Yeah, it was fantastic. I love that music video too. Anyways. So President Trump is trying to go backward in time, and it's a bad idea. It's an anachronistic idea. Okay? America is no longer a third world country, developing country. So manufacturing job is not gonna work. Why? Because there will be no job satisfaction. Okay? All this labor intensive job, it will not work in America. Okay? The only way for those labor intensive job to work in America is by bringing in illegal immigrants. Why? Because illegal immigrants are the only one who is willing to do those dirty works, those labor intensive jobs. Americans, born and raised Americans, educated Americans, they will not do those jobs. Okay? So President Trump brought back all this manufacturing labor intensive job that used to be in South America. Now he's bringing it back to America. Now those third world country people are following those jobs because they are okay with those jobs, and those labor intensive jobs are very poorly paid jobs. So only illegal immigrants can fit these jobs because they are very poorly paid jobs. Americans, born and raised Americans, will not do those jobs. Okay? That's why it's a bad idea. President Trump, he doesn't know. Economists, they don't know it either. I mean, look at us. We are correcting this neoclassical economic theory. For 100 years, did economists like who went to Cambridge, Harvard, MIT, they didn't know this, that supply-demand curve was wrong for 100 years, okay? People are not very smart, okay? Even though they may have gone to Harvard, Yale, Stanford, Cambridge, Oxford. No, that's still stupid, all right? Oh, they may become President Obama, President Clinton, President Trump. They're still very stupid people, okay? And look what they're doing. Oh, they say gay marriage is okay, come on. Oh, even the four-star generals who went to West Point, they're still very, very smart, stupid people. Why? Because look at them. They think gay marriage is okay and transgender is okay. Okay, how more stupid can it get? They think tattoos are okay, piercing is okay, marijuana is okay, everything is okay as long as it's majority, mainstream. They are not leadership materials, okay? All these elites, they should never be in leadership position. Maybe 1% of them, okay? But not like 99% like today in Washington, D.C. with President Trump administration, President Obama administration. No, elites, they are not leadership materials. They are more like leaders, obeyers, employees. Because all they do is obey, do the homework, follow the majority, follow the rules. That's how they became elites. Like, that's how they could go ahead and go to like Harvard, Yale, Stanford, because they work so hard, like workaholics, to obey and do the homework. And they are good learners, and they are good teachers too. Yeah, they are good librarians, basically, good keepers of knowledge. But they are not leadership materials. That's what I'm trying to tell you, okay? And they are not good at creating new theories either. Why? Because they lack creativity and they lack leadership, okay? So that's one problem in academia. It's getting too complicated because it's too superficial, or they try to decorate their theory with all this fancy mathematics, fancy statistics. They try to hide the lack of substance by obfuscating it, by making it very difficult to read and understand. That's today's American academia, okay? Not just in economics, everywhere. What time is it? Yeah, I gotta go somewhere, okay? The political meeting, and of course after I get sober, so don't worry about that. So what else do we talk about? So yeah, if I become the president, there will be no State of Union and congressional session. It will be all done online, okay, in the internet with the teleconferencing, whatever, okay. There will be no more travel of federal employees, period. No. If they are going to travel, they will use their own money and they'll use their own leave time, vacation time. Okay, otherwise, make phone call, okay? Make phone call, do teleconferencing, do whatever, internet, whatever, okay? Skype, whatever. There will be no more Washington, D.C. people. So draining the swamp is the correct idea, okay? I give President Trump that credit. But he's not capable of doing it. He's just replacing a swamp with another swamp, okay? He didn't replace anything, actually. I mean, the same people running the show, like elites, okay? He just happened to be Manhattan elite, okay? Now he's replaced just one person or a few people. He replaced Washington elites with Manhattan elites. It's not Eric Kushner, it's Jared Kushner. Okay. He, his wife, his son-in-law, all these dumb people in his family, yeah, he brought with him, and then, yeah. It's not making any improvement. I guess he's not too bad. I still think he's less of two evil between Madam Secretary Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. Yeah, I think he was less of two evils, but still, I am the least satisfied, okay, because I can do a lot better than that, okay. Well, first of all, there will be no State of Union speech, okay. If there is, then it will be just me talking in front of camera, live camera, in the White House, and there will be no audience. I hate wasting my time or other people's time. It will be very efficient government, okay? Senators, congressmen, they will all go back to their own state. They will not be in Washington, D.C., getting bad with lobbyists, no. They should be taking care of their own people. What happens when you become a politician is this: you get elected, you forget people who voted for you. You just only hang out with the richest motherfuckers on the planet. The so-called important people, okay? Once you get elected to an elected position, high position in a government, like in a state government or federal government, you become an elite. So you only hang out with the richest motherfuckers on the planet, okay? So-called the most important people. Okay, then you forget about all the people who voted for you, okay? That's what happens. I'm sorry, but it's just the way it is, and it has been always that way. I mean, look at King Solomon, King David. They got corrupted after they became the king. There was not a single king in the kingdom of Israel who satisfied God. Later on, after God made him king, they all got corrupted. Even King David, even King Solomon, King Saul, all of them, all of them. Every single one of them. And Stalin, Lenin, right? Or all this communist revolution, like in Cuba, we have Fidel Castro. They're all great deceivers. Or Kim Jong-un, Kim Jong-il, like Kim Il-sung. Yeah, all these great dictators. Or Mao Zedong, right? Chairman Mao. They're all same. Great deceivers. They deceive uneducated, stupid people like all of us. Okay? They say, oh, you'll be different. You know, I will take all the rich people's money and distribute it to you. Lies. Okay, so stupid poor people like us. Oh, yeah. Okay, our money, you know, free handouts. Yeah, take money from rich people and give it to me. That'd be nice. So I vote for him, and then what does he do once he gets elected? Oh, you know what? I'm going to take all the rich people's money and I'll take it to myself. Okay, and not only that, my regime will last until I die, and after that, I will give my power to my son. Okay, so, and nothing has ever changed since the back in the way back old days when there was this middle age, dark age, these kings and inheritance of this kingdom from father king and son prince. Okay, nothing has ever changed since then, okay? It's all the same, okay? Democracy, come on. It's democracy, it's a plutocracy, it's ruled by money. Elitocracy, ruled by elites. That's today's American democracy. That is known to be the best democracy in the world, okay? So it's not something I would blindly praise. I'm just giving you some constructive criticism, okay? Because we should do a lot better, because right now it's not too bad, but I am the least satisfied. I'm being very nice to be like this. I'm saying it so nicely. I'm making a conscious effort now. Okay. So yeah, there will be no more these big meetings, big travels by federal government employees. Okay, they will not be traveling. We'll do all phone call, teleconferencing, Skype, that's it. They should go back to their state and talk to common people like us. Listen to what the problems are, what the solutions might be. Senators, congressmen should be talking to people like us, like you and me. People who are not famous. People who are not rich. People who are not important. That's how democracy should be. Ruled by the people, representative government. Senators, congressmen, they should go back to their state and start listening and talking to people like us, rather than sending out all this custom email. Yeah, not custom email, it's never customized email. Yeah, just this copy and paste email that sent to everybody who ever wrote to them. Because I have wrote to congressmen, senators, even the President Trump. I have written them. It's just copy and paste email or mail, okay? Why? Because they are too busy meeting so-called important people, rich people, powerful people, like CEOs of big corporations. Oh, they love them, you know? Senators, congressmen, presidents. Yeah, they only meet with the most important people, okay? And it should stop, because that's not democracy. That's not democracy, okay? Congressmen, senators, they should go back to their state and start talking to their people, common people like us. Okay? That's what they should be doing. And then, yeah, have a meeting, but it will be phone call, teleconference, Skype, whatever, internet. They should not be traveling like they're doing now. They're wasting money, taxpayers' money, okay? I'm all about giving money back to the people, okay? Stop all this stupid waste. You have internet, use it. We have cell phone, telephone, use it. Why do you have to fly all the way to Washington, D.C.? They want to meet all the lobbyists, okay? All corporate party. All these big money men or these famous people, CEOs. That's why they are there. To have a big party, fancy corporate party. That's why they are in D.C. Washington, D.C. is a party town for the most rich and the most powerful. We need to change that. Because that's not democracy, okay? They're like vampires sucking up blood of poor people like us. I understand this sounds like the rhetoric of a socialist, communist. I know, because I know about socialism and communism. And I don't like socialism and communism, okay? But maybe I have something in common with them, actually, okay? Because I'm trying to appeal to 99% of Americans who are not rich, okay? Maybe 90% of Americans who are middle income level or less, okay? So yeah, when I'm the president, it will be radically different, okay? Yeah, send senators, congressmen back to their own states, and they are not coming back to Washington ever. Oh, okay. At least when I'm the president, I will kick them out of Washington, D.C., okay? I don't want them there. I don't want to see them. I don't want to meet them. I want them out of there. I want them to go back to their freaking states and take care of their good people, not freaking people. They need to take care of their people. Listen to them, come up with a solution, real world problem, real people's problems, okay? Rather than coming up with some intellectually challenging, non-existent problem like climate change. What do you do with climate change? Intellectually challenging. It doesn't exist, okay? It exists, so what? You don't have to do anything about climate change, okay? It's all garbage, okay? It's a waste of time to think about it, okay? Just adapt and adjust. Just don't even think about it. Climate change. Garbage, man. Okay, so I will stop all this nonsense, alright, when I'm the president. What if I don't become the president? Easy. I keep running, okay? I keep running until I die. Probably may not. I don't know. Yeah, you know, if I become president, that'd be nice, okay? But if I don't, yeah, I'll keep running until I die. Okay? And I'll keep doing this. Alright? Okay. What time is it? What time is it? We're gonna take a brief break, okay? Then we'll be back, and yeah, because I gotta go somewhere, okay? Political meeting. After I get sober, of course. So don't worry about me, okay? So we'll take a break and we'll talk about. We at least try to finish this notes, okay? This note topics, okay? Thank you. Okay, I'm cooking my dinner at the same time in the microwave. So.
Ah, boy. So.
Okay, so anchor baby, like, you know, birth tourism situation. Yeah, we need to stop that. Okay, I think it's bad. Okay, and some people tell me, hey, aren't you on anchor baby? I kind of have this semblance, similarity to anchor baby, but I'm not. Why? Because do you know what my parents want me to do? They want me to come back to Korea, marry a Korean girl, have Korean babies, and live with them. That's what they want me to do. My parents came to America to study, okay? They got scholarship, I mean, my dad. My mom, yeah, she married my dad in Korea, okay? And my dad is very hardworking, smart guy, so he applied to American schools, and he got scholarship to come over there. Okay, that's my dad. And not just my dad. A lot of men in South Korea, China, India, Japan, they're excellent scholars. So America wanted them to come over there and contribute to academia. Okay, because Asians are known to be academically hardworking, okay? Yeah, they work, study hard, so yeah, they wanted to come to America, learn, and also contribute. And that's what my dad did. And I just happened to be born in America. And they preserved my dual citizenship as I grew up in Korea because they wanted to give me a choice. And they were right. Why? Because my personality doesn't quite fit this Korean culture. Korean culture is great, but it tends to be too limited. And I'm bigger than that. Okay, and look at me, I'm going everywhere, right? Yeah, so Korea doesn't quite fit my personality, and they're all right. And thanks to American government and Korean government and my parents, Korean parents, yeah, they gave me a choice to choose between two countries, and I chose America, okay? Yeah, Korean government, they were generous to me too, so that they gave me an option to choose. Okay. Yeah. So I have lived in America. I was born in America, okay. And I have lived in America for more than 2 decades, okay? And no, I'm not going back to Korea, okay? If America kicked me out, then yeah, I may. If Korean government accepts me. Otherwise, I will have to find a country to go to. Okay, if Korean government does not want me, American government does not want me, then yeah, I have to go somewhere. I'm not gonna just commit suicide or anything. I will keep trying to find a country who'd accept me. Okay, that can happen. It happened before with Charlie Chaplin. Charlie Chaplin, he got kicked out of America, okay? He went to Switzerland or something because he was accused of being a communist or something. Whatever. So yeah, that can happen to me. And so yeah, when I'm the president, he'll be like this, okay? I'm not gonna tax the rich and give it to the poor, no. That's a very communist idea, and I'm not going to do that because I don't like communism or socialism. I don't. Okay? But I will voluntarily reduce my presidential salary level to average American salary level. Okay? And I will be talking to only average Americans. Okay? That's what I'm going to be doing. Okay? Because that's 90% of Americans, they're not rich people, 90%, okay? They know what the problems are and they know what the solutions are, and we're gonna do it, okay? Rich people, they have no problems. They just wanna party. And that's what politicians do. Look at all this State of Union speech yesterday. Big party, right? Oh, standing ovation, idolatry. Oh, President Trump, yeah. Worship, yeah, bow down. You know, that's what Washington DC is all about. Okay, rich people. They don't have any problem to solve. But they are rich, they have a lot of money. They got inheritance money, secure job, power, money, fame. Yeah, they have it all. They don't have any problem. They don't get to experience the problems that we are facing. We are trying to make ends meet, and we have to deal with the crimes, right? Because we don't have bodyguards like rich people do. We don't have Secret Service. Probably when I'm the president, I don't think I would want to have Secret Service around me, to be honest. Okay? So I may just have a few friends of mine around me who are not Secret Service agents, okay? And if I want to party, I would just go to regular clubs in DC or regular bars, okay? Most likely, I would just drink in the White House when I'm the president, if I'm the president, okay? That's what I do. I don't party outside. I drink at home. I party in my home, okay? So that I can drink, so that I don't have to drive back home, okay? All I need is YouTube, okay? And this disco light. I showed you once, right? Yeah, I have disco lights. It's something cheap, okay? I bought it from Amazon. Just a rotating, you know, on the ceiling, you know. It's not on the ceiling, it's on the floor, but it shines this colorful light on the, and rotates it toward the ceiling, so. Why am I talking about disco ball, man? Okay, so yeah, bar tourism and Anchor Baby, yeah, I don't like that idea, but yeah, I'm not one of them, okay? Yeah, so President Trump has changed because I used to like him a lot, but he became more like a politician, okay? I didn't like the tonality of his voice yesterday's so-to speech. It's too unctuous. Do you know what this word is? Unction, unctuous, like oily and so complacent and so happy, you know, oh, I'm happy, I'm the president. Disgusting. Oh, this fucking disgusting. Yeah, so he became just one of them. Politicians. Okay. Yeah. So I don't like him anymore. Okay. So I'm not gonna vote for him next time. Okay. Will I vote for myself? Probably not. Probably I vote for some unknown third party candidate, I guess. I'm not gonna vote for Democratic candidate either, okay? But I'm not voting for President Trump. That's because I don't want him there anymore, okay? I'm trying to replace him, okay? And I'm not asking for your money. To be honest with you, I don't want your money. And I don't want your time either, okay? That's my campaign slogan. Give money, power, time back to the people, okay? I don't want you to waste time on me. No, why don't you take care of your kids, okay? Or take care of yourself. Yeah, go exercise, diet, learn a new foreign language, okay? Don't spend time on me, all right? If you are here, yeah, I don't think it's a waste of time if you're watching this. Because we are learning something together, okay? All right, what else? Okay, temptation of politicians. So yeah, I guess we can do some kind of acting. We just don't have time. I have to go somewhere. Okay, we do it briefly, okay? Like in audition, you have like what, 5 minutes audition, right? Your monologue. I do this dialogue audition because I'm gonna play two characters. a man and a woman. Let's say I'm a big time politician, okay? And there's a beautiful young girl, okay? And she comes to me and, hello. Oh, hi.
Hey, I want to have sex with you and you don't have to pay me. What do you say?
Okay, so you're a beautiful young girl and you want to have sex with me for free. What's the catch?
Oh, there is no catch. You are big time politician, so I'm very attracted to you and I want to have sex with you. That's all. I think it will be very fun. I think it will be the best sex ever. Like what Carla Marple said. What was that her name? Carla Marple? Carla Marple.
The second wife of President Trump, okay?
Yeah.
No, you know, I think somebody sent you, somebody paid you to have sex with me, and maybe you'll invite me to your house and there will be this secret video camera footage and they'll be recording me getting naked and having sex with you, and maybe you're being paid by my political opponent so that they will send this sex tape between you and me to broadcasting television station, and of course they will edit it a little bit, but yeah, I think, yeah, my political opponent sent you because I know about women, okay? Women don't do that stuff. Okay, so that's the temptation of politician, okay? A temptation on politician. That's that. What's this? Okay, so hypothetically, okay? Political fiction, political fantasy, okay? I imagine myself to be on a debate stage, national debate stage with President Trump. President Trump would ask me, hey, you don't have any leadership experience. Have you ever run a big corporation? I would say, no. Okay, then how can you run a country, man? I would say, Mr. President, have you ever been an average American? Have you ever experienced a life as an average American? No, I was born rich and I've been always the boss. I have always been the employer. Yeah, I have always been rich, and so no. Okay, so I guess then I just don't think you care about average American people, and I don't think you really care. I don't think you really understand what average Americans go through, middle income Americans or less. Yeah, because you've never been middle income class. You've been always high class, right? So you don't know what the problems are, and I don't think you even care about it, okay? Yeah, you don't know what the problems are and you have no solutions because you don't know what the problems are. Of course you don't know the solutions. So yeah, I don't think you are fit to be a president, okay? I voted for you just because you are not as bad as Madam Secretary Hillary Clinton, okay? So that's that. So, okay, schools, okay? I think schools, not just schools, not just teachers, American public schools, okay? Teachers and all the American parents, okay? Maybe most of them, all right? I think all they teach their children, teenagers, young children, is that, yeah, go ahead, do teenage dating, have sex, drop out of school, do tattoos, piercings, do marijuana, be obese, sugar, fat. I think that's what parents and teachers in America are teaching, okay? Because look what's happening to this so-called millennials, this new generation. Tattooed, pierced, obese, teenage pregnancy, abortion, ultra-interracialism, tattoos, piercings, marijuana, yeah. And they don't know anything. They are ignorant. They are uneducated. They don't know mathematics. They don't know physics. They don't know biology. They know nothing. All they know is, oh, gay marriage, let's become gay, dyke, lesbian, let's be transgender. That's all they know. This brand new American generation, that's all they know. Oh, yeah, smoke marijuana. Oh, alcohol is bad, tobacco bad. Smoke marijuana instead. Yeah, do tattoos, piercings instead, blah, blah, okay? I think that's the only thing that parents and teachers are teaching in America. Because that's all they know, okay? All they know is gay marriage, transgender, tattoos, piercings, obesity, sugar, fat, marijuana, ultra-interracialism, you know, ethnic men marrying, dating, young, beautiful white girl, on teenage dating, teenage pregnancies, dropping out of school. I think that's the only thing American parents and teachers are teaching. Because that's all they are doing. That's all they know how to. They don't know physics, they don't know history, they know nothing, they don't know foreign language, okay? Sad. Next. What is this? I cannot read my own handwriting, okay? So, market share, okay. They say, oh, alcohol is bad, tobacco is bad. It's because of this. It's a market share competition, okay? So all these food companies, snacking companies, like they, who make chocolates, candies, you know, sugar and fat, cakes, ice cream. Yeah, they're competing with tobacco and alcohol industry, okay? Because people only have so much money to spend some fun food, fun drinks, okay? So all these sugar and fat companies are competing with tobacco and alcohol companies, okay? So that's why they condemn tobacco and alcohol, because people can have 90% of Americans are poor like me and you, okay? So they have only so much money. It's either they buy sugar and fat or they buy tobacco and alcohol. They cannot purchase both because they don't have that much money. So yeah, it's a market share. So all this sugar fat company, they are the ones who are investing on this anti-tobacco, anti-alcohol advertisement. I think they are behind it, okay? Not only them, big pharma, pharmaceutical companies are also anti-tobacco, anti-alcohol advertisement, I think. Why? Hey, don't do tobacco, don't do alcohol, eat our drugs instead. Prescription drugs, opioids. Marijuana, yeah, smoke marijuana, don't do tobacco, don't do alcohol, yeah, smoke marijuana instead, okay? So yeah, it's a market competition, okay? This, and ladies and gentlemen, tobacco and alcohol is better than any of those things, okay? Because it's time-proven and space-proven. Tobacco and alcohol has the longest history of all those drugs. Tobacco, alcohol is a drug. They're drugs, okay? They're proven to be healthier and safer than all other kinds of drugs. So that's why tobacco and alcohol have endured past the test of time and space and culture, okay? All across the globe over thousands of years, yeah, tobacco and alcohol survived, and it's still, okay. All these other prescription drugs and opioids, weeds, this tattoo piercing and marijuana is gonna all gonna evaporate, okay. All right, that's all I have to say for now, and I have to eat, get sober, brush my teeth and go to this meeting, okay? After I come back from this meeting, probably I will continue and start talking about economics, okay? Because we talked about all the other issues, right? All right, see you soon. Bye.